sellers for?
My lord, you of all people should know that too many voices muddy the message. That is why there is one lord above all. And so there must be one advisor above the rest. There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I understand. I'll do it now.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good sores have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength. And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, oh, you know, don't you?
You honour Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad, you can't steal. That's a rule.
Well, I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him. To help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
I must be firm. I'm not a boy anymore, and there is too much at stake.
The Lord's work can harden a man. It's true.
But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice, and I'd trust him.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you. Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. I know you told me you'd have to change, but I suppose I hadn't believed you would.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
I wish Father were here.
You all do, but Father is gone. You are the lord of this house, which is why you must be strong. You're just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were. I know it. I only wish you did too.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Sword up! Swing left! Parry! Wrong! I didn't know dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. What's the state of our defences? Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, but they will be. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny, and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre. That'll show Ramsay we're a force in our own right. You've got to project power, especially when you're weakened.
Thank you, Sir Roiland. I'll let you get back to training these men.
Thank you, my lord. And I'll be sure to watch out for more deserters. After today, I suspect there'll be more to come. Yes, my lord.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins, or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrod to the wall. He undermined your authority, and made you look weak to the Whitehills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud, seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
Your words are wise, Sir Roiland.
Thank you, my lord.
I will consider them as I make my choice.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrod away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrod had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the Whitehills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
I understand. And you're forgiven.
Thank you, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Slash and parry! Slash and parry! Again!
Maester?
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Whomever's not chosen should feel no shame. Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision. Sir Roiland de Gore, you will be my sentinel.
Gods be praised. You've done well, Lord Ethan. You won't regret this.
A poor choice, my lord. Forgive me for saying so, but it's true.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
My scouts say he's a day's ride away. We've no time to waste. He'll arrive before any of our allies could be here.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can handle Ramsay Snow. He doesn't scare me.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls.
Quiet, Tuttle. You're not the Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the small council, is it not?
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand. Put every man who can hold a spear or crossbow on the wall and make the bastard fill his boots with piss.
He would see it for the empty gesture that it is and have us flayed. We must take a measured approach, my lord.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
We all must agree on the plan. We cannot leave until we have a consensus.
Ugh.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough! Although Sir Roiland may object, I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Wait. Let him gaze upon Ironrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him at the gate.
Very good, my lord. I shall prepare the men.
Men? We hardly have any. It's a foolish plan.
That's enough from you, Tuttle. Lord Ethan has spoken. Obey his command.
I've faithfully served this house for far too long to sit here and listen to this.
Forgive me, my lord, but you are far too young to be the lord of this house. You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow at the gate, and we will not offer our ironwood.
No matter what, I will stand beside you, my lord, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house.
Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister.
Why would you bring him back after you exiled him?
He exiled himself. He has no desire to rule. Asher is volatile, but that is his strength too. Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but you do not have that anger inside you. It's something we could use.
I'm not like that. But I don't need to be, do I?
No. But you need someone who is standing beside you. I'm trying to do what's best for this family. What this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the King. I thought you'd want to know. Thank you. Mira, look. The other day when you asked Lady Marjorie for help, I only spoke out of fear for her. I want to help you if there's anything I can do. Your poor family. I can't imagine how you must feel.
You're sweet to offer, Sarah. Thank you.
Lady Marjorie is always saying how important friends and allies are in King's Landing. Just know, I will be here for you if you ever... My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family, if you'll excuse me, my lady.
Milady. Begging your pardon, milady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I hope you saw. I was right before, about Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things.
Things that could be useful for you.
It's too dangerous for me right now. And for you as well.
You needn't worry about me. I can take care of myself. Which is why you must trust me, milady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair.
I know people who...
People who'd be willing to help you.
Where the bloody hell is Duncan? Now fuck him if he's angry. And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men are ready to act if needed.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
Bolton men approaching, my lord!
Something wrong with your gate? Well, aren't you the little lord? No wonder you can't open the gate. Shall we help you? Now let me in. This is a lovely pile of timber, isn't it?
You may enter.
Oh, may we? How gracious of the Lord to allow us in. And you said he wasn't a proper lord.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forester Ironwood.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. Quite the army you have, Lord Forrester. Very impressive. Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
Force him to focus on the business at hand.
Lord Ramsay, I understand you've come here for assurance of our fealty.
Fealty? We came here for justice.
We'll get to your justice. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father, Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal. I want you to show me.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
No, Lord Ramsay.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton. Yet your man lived.
Lord Whitehill is a liar. That's not how it happened.
Lad? A liar? He's a Whitehill. You had me stand out in the wind and muck so you could show off your pathetic little army. That sort of insult.